Hey everyone, and welcome back. So today I wanted to give my first impressions and also show you some gameplay of an upcoming Switch game called Ebenezer and the Invisible World that will actually be releasing on November 3rd of this year. Now this game is a Metroidvania and it's actually set within the world of A Christmas Carol, with Ebenezer Scrooge being the main protagonist behind the game. Now we're not actually going to watch the whole opening cutscene here, however, I will give you a breakdown of the storyline. The reason why is because the cutscene is actually almost 7 minutes long, and it gives a lot of details that maybe aren't essential to understanding the gameplay you're about to see. Now the events in this game are actually post A Christmas Carol, so Ebenezer has already gone through the whole storyline where he met the ghost of Christmas past, present, and future, and he's now a really generous and kind person. And when the game starts out, Ebenezer is being visited by a spirit once again. However, this time the spirit is asking for his help, because they're basically trying to do the same thing that they did to him with another industrialist. However, unfortunately, the plan backfired. Because unfortunately, when this industrialist got visited by the ghost of Christmas Future, he got a glimpse of the moment of his death. And it was the exact same moment that he made the biggest invention, and he was supposed to get to the point where he realized that unfortunately he was never going to be able to profit from it, because unfortunately he would die the moment he invented it. But when he gets back, he's actually visited by a malevolent spirit, and that malevolent spirit, the spirit of his father, convinces him that rather a better plan is that since he actually saw the device he's going to invent in the future, to invent it more rapidly and basically change the whole timeline. So yes, this almost becomes a multiverse, protect the timeline story thrown into A Christmas Carol. And I'll be honest with you guys, that is one of the only things that for the moment is still throwing me off with the whole setup. I mean, if you get into it, the storyline makes sense. To me, what never made sense is seeing Ebenezer Scrooge as an action hero, because this is an action Metroidvania. Scrooge does a lot of combat in it, and in most representations of Ebenezer Scrooge, he's a more elderly, frail individual, and I'm still not 100% wrapping my mind around him being like an Indiana Jones adventure type character. And honestly, in between the different storyline elements, I often even forget that I'm playing as Ebenezer. But overall, the storyline still makes sense if you really commit to believing it. I just find they could have maybe thrown this sort of setting into a lot of other franchises and it feel more natural. Now, if we talk first about the art style and visuals, I find the game is really beautiful, and especially the art style during the different cutscenes. Really, really top-notch stuff. Animations, however, during the game, for the moment, are a little stuttery in moments. However, by the way, the developer says there's a day one patch coming. Don't forget this is a pre-release copy of the game, and that day one patch is supposed to smooth everything out. And personally, so far, it hasn't affected my gameplay experience. It's just at certain moments, you can see some small stutters and some frame rate drops. But at least it's nothing jarring, and as I said, didn't affect my gameplay. And gameplay-wise, well, this game is modeling itself very closely to a sort of Symphony of the Night design, with different rooms that are specific save rooms, and really all the components you would see in Symphony of the Night, except for one. And that's the fact that in this game, you actually don't acquire XP from defeating enemies, which means that combat can actually be avoided with very little downside. But also, due to the placement of the enemies, there's no way to avoid all combat, and secondly, it will serve you to upgrade your special spirit abilities, because some spirit abilities do evolve once you've killed a certain number of enemies using them. So it's not a direct XP system, but there is a little bit of advantage to actually going through combat. Also, I almost forgot, collectibles. Killing enemies will give you some collectibles, which once again will be used to upgrade different items and abilities later on. Now, central to the gameplay, as I mentioned earlier, are those spirit abilities. Early in the game, you'll meet your first spirit, which will become an ally of yours, and it's sort of giving you your special abilities. You'll actually be collecting a variety of spirits throughout the gameplay, and at this point, I do want to mention I am embargoed on some of the late game information and how far I can show you in the game, so that's why we're doing a first impressions today, because I can't actually talk about the end game here or show you footage beyond a certain point. But these spirit abilities are really where the Metroidvania aspect of the gameplay comes in, because your access to certain areas will be restricted till you receive these abilities. As you make your way around the map, you'll also receive various quests and also side quests. The good news, however, the side quests so far have not been very complicated to complete, and as long as you explore the map meticulously, you'll pretty much complete most of them. And the fun thing is, they do give you access to some more powerful spirit abilities. Now, aside from the spirit abilities, you'll also be collecting new weapons, which will have some various characteristics, like giving you a longer attack range, a faster attack range. You'll also be collecting heirlooms, which will give you specific abilities, like the ability to run faster, jump higher, things like that. And you can have 4 active at any time, and the game seems to have a few dozen. Now that we've broken down the storyline and the gameplay, what are my overall first impressions? Well, first of all, for a Metroidvania being sold at a $20 price point, I think it's a very good offering so far, especially if they can smooth out those few little glitches in that first patch. Also, they're promising to increase the attack damage a little bit and reduce the HP for the enemies, because one downside that you'll probably see in the gameplay, some enemies do end up being damage sponges. And it does reduce the fun of the combat a little bit, especially because you have some very slow attack animations and you're actually locked in the animation when you're doing it, meaning you can't actually dodge till the animation's complete. It does make the overall combat system feel a little bit clunky, and you really have to think about each attack before you make it, because if not, it just might cost you some damage. But the exploration in the game is actually fun. The way the different map is set up actually works nicely, because when you get abilities, you have to do very little backtracking. It often loops around to where you need to be going next. But maybe on the downside, at least for the moment, the boss fights that I've gone through have been a little bit lackluster, not really offering anything new I haven't seen before. So what I can say for the moment is it looks like it's turning out to be a very solid Metroidvania, offering a good experience, especially at this price point. It just, I don't think, will become a revolutionary one. And you know what? If you can wrap your head around Ebenezer Scrooge actually being an action hero, this could be a really good pickup. At this point, this is pretty much everything I had to say for the moment about my first impressions. Hopefully, we'll be coming back with a full review by November 3rd. So now I'll leave you with some more gameplay that I can show you. I hope you'll enjoy it, and let me know what you're thinking in the comments down below. Don't forget, at the same time, if you haven't already, to hit that like button, subscribe to the channel if you aren't already, click on that notification bell so you know when all my future videos come out. And as usual, I hope I'll see you in my next video.
Thank you.